swear to uphold the principles of our order and all that for which we stand?
I do.
And never to share our secrets nor divulge the true nature of our work?
I do.
And to do so from now until death, whatever the cost?
I do.
Then we welcome you into our fold, brother. You are now a Templar, harbinger of a new world. May the Father of Understanding guide us.
May the Father of Understanding guide us.
Do you understand now?
I'm starting to see why you're so interested in Shay Cormac.
Shay has seen the true face of the world. And he has chosen his path accordingly. A similar choice will soon present itself to you.
I did not think you'd get this far, but you seem to be on the right track. We still can't access the servers in the basement, but there's another one located at the top of the building near Melanie's office. That's your next stop.
I'm bored out of my skull. But orders are orders, and my orders are to stand right here.
This office used to belong to a man named Olivier Garneau. He was my predecessor as chief creative officer of Abstergo Entertainment. Otto Berg is a representative from our parent company, Abstergo Industries. He's showing you the true history of the world, just like they showed me. Olivier was kind, he was intelligent and passionate about our work, but a year ago, he caught a glimpse of this truth. They never found his body. This is not the way we normally bring people up to speed on these matters, but you've worked hard and are proving yourself, so I'm granting you level 2 security access. The servers on this floor should unlock more of Shay's memories.
Servers up and running now.
François Macandal saved Baptiste from slavery and inducted him into his so-called brotherhood. Macandal was a vicious mentor, And in his desperate attempt to liberate slaves, he broke his own creed by indiscriminately killing nobles. Misguided as they are, some assassins are honorable. Macandal was not one of them. Thanks to the calculating genius of Madeleine de Lille, the Templars made an example of Macandal by way of public execution in 1758. His pathetic excuse for a brotherhood quickly fell apart. When his comrade and childhood friend Agathe fled to Louisiana, Baptiste saw the futility of his former life in Macandal's brotherhood. Madeleine saw Baptiste's potential and instructed her Templars in New Orleans to strike a deal with him. If he could draw Agathe out of hiding and eliminate him, he would be granted a place in the Templar order. Although Baptiste was killed by the assassin Aveline de Grandpré, his path clearly demonstrates the inherent superiority of Templar ideals over assassin terrorism.
I've got your animus ready and waiting.
Just saying that Violet didn't have to yell at us for not fixing the elevator before she did.
Ugh. Shit! What's happening?
Another glitch?
Same one as before. Shay's back at Notre Dame.
See if you can complete the memory this time.
Shay's in Paris, all right. I even got a date for you. 1776.
At this point in time, Franklin was the American ambassador to France.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Otto Berg, professional killer and amateur historian.
Should not have left your backwater colony.
Well,
Shay? Is that you? Ah, how long has it been? Where are my manners? Thank you, my friend, thank you. But what are you doing in Paris?
With all due respect, sir, this is no time to talk. You're still in danger.
Yes, I must return to my family.
Oh.
Thank you, Shay. Please, wait for me. I just want to make sure my family is safe. Everyone is safe and sound. These ruffians
have followed us. There's more of them.
How? How did you do that? It was quite fortunate.
I make my own luck, Master Franklin, as I suspect you do.
Yes, indeed, my good fellow. Yet, without your assistance today... Well, you have my thanks, Shay. Is there anything I can do for you to repay you for this kindness?
Actually, there is. I need to meet a business acquaintance. I heard he would be at the Chateau de Versailles 2 days from now.
And they don't just let anyone inside the royal palace. Very well. I'll see what can be arranged.
That's the best we can do for now. We keep trying to sequence memories out of order, which is why we're crashing like this.
What do you suggest?
If we progress further with Shay's life in the colonies, I'm confident we can get better results from these Paris memories.
Very well. Keep me informed.
Uploading the next memory sequence now.
Shay Cormac. I hear you are the Templar's new don of precursor archaeology.
I'm no expert, sir. I just witnessed what the assassins can do with those damn sites.
I have spent years investigating precursor leads. Tell me what you have seen.
Well, I know both the assassins and Templars are looking for pieces of Eden. Powerful weapons, mind control and apples, but this time it's different. We haven't found an apple, but a tree. These temples hold the earth together like roots. Disturb them and Haiti falls, or Lisbon, or any other place the manuscript shows.
And the assassins are blindly interfering with these structures?
Aye. And if we don't stop them, they'll continue destroying cities.
I see. We have intelligence of assassin activity near Louisbourg Fortress. We'll be meeting with a Royal Navy officer, James Cook. He recently gained a commission that could be strategically valuable. Gist has the charts.
Very well. I'll depart shortly.
Colonel Monroe spoke highly of you, Shay. He was convinced you could become the best among us. I expect you will not disappoint.
I don't plan to, sir.
Gist, do you know why the Grand Master is so interested in Captain Cook?
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid in Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of strict honesty and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep secret business secret, especially when his mathematical brain is clever at cracking codes. Consider him an ally, but watch what you say around him.
Duly noted.
I've heard Louisbourg could be a linchpin in the war. If the Royal Navy can take that fort, it'll be clear sailing down the St. Lawrence.
Then on to Quebec and Montreal. The tide is turning.
General Wolfe will give that craven Montcalm a right thrashing.
I've been looking forward to that since Fort William Henry.
With this bloody war over, we'll finally bring order to this den. There she is, the HMS Pembroke, Captain James Cook's ship.
She's a beauty.
Man of war, fully armed. We should bring the Morrigan alongside. Master Kenway will surely be waiting.
Welcome aboard, gentlemen.
Good to see you again, Captain.
Captain Shay Cormac, Captain James Cook.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Pleasure's mine, sir.
Captain Cook uncovered a rather distressing stratagem, which I fear confirms our own intelligence.
Indeed. As we speak, our Royal Navy fleet is on its way to Louisbourg. However, the French have drawn up a preemptive strike against it. If they launch this attack...
Obviously, we cannot allow that to happen. Gentlemen, the Battle of Louisbourg could very well be the turning point which will finally bring this war to a close.
I don't know about you, but... I've had enough of war.
Then may I suggest you take the wheel, Captain Cormac? I think you might enjoy piloting a vessel with real, firepower.
I believe I shall, Captain.
Lawrence and Whitmore lead the three divisions of the Royal Navy.
Who's their commander?
Major General Amherst himself, back from Hanover.
You take an interest in the war, Shay?
Wouldn't want to disappoint you, sir. Not let any through.
It is imperative we stop those ships, Captain. The outcome of the war depends on it.
Make use of your own mortars, Shay. You'll prove crucial if we are to succeed.
gallants! We can heat! Keep fire out of the way! She'll ram us!
Fire! Fire! Fire!
She's sunk!
Fire!
Let out some sail!
Ready to fire!
Fire!
More sail!
Dear God, fire ships. Should they break through, they would devastate our fleet.
We'd better not let that happen.
I recognize that vessel, sir. It's the Experto Crede.
Adwale.
How fortunate he is that we have other priorities.
Agreed. We have to get rid of those fire ships.
We have to sink that fire ship or get out of their way.
Those mortars, Shay.
Fire! Fire!
More enemy ships, sir! And more fire ships!
This is hopeless, but absolutely wiser to fall back.
Foreign wisdom don't always mix, Captain. Foreign wisdom don't always mix, Captain. This isn't over yet, lads. Man the cannons! Yeah!
There's the Royal Navy!
We cleared the way just in time, Captain Cormac.
The tide of war is turning!
That was quite a crack, wasn't it?
It is too soon for celebrations. Adwale is still out there.
I'm sure we'll get another turn to dance with him, Master Kenway.